Faithful God, faithful Father, faithful Dad, we give a glory, Lord. Ye kalata la kalibra gusa taya, rekata la kalibra gusa taya kalibra kataya, rakata la kalibra gusa taya kalibra kataya, rekata la kalibra gusa taya kalibra kataya, rekata la kalibra gusa taya kalataya, ata la kalibra gusa kagalata la kalataya, rekata la kalibra gusa taya kalataya, rekata la baba la kalibra gusa taya kalataya. Oh, Father, you are worthy. Daddy God, you are worthy. Bless every God. You are worthy, Jesus. You are worthy. You are worthy to be glorified. You are worthy, Ebenezer. You are worthy. You are worthy to be glorified. Hallelujah. You are worthy, Jesus. You are worthy. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
faithful, Lord. You are mighty, Lord. Great Alagama, Alagama. Oh, give ears to my words, oh Lord. Consider my meditation. Oh,
I give God the praise. Worship you, Lord, believe. To worship you, Lord, believe. Reconnect the consortium and the Galatea. Rakanabo consortium and the Galatea. Rakanabo consortium and the Galatea. Wherever you are, everybody, lift your voice and worship our Redeemer. Worship the Creator of the universe. Worship the one that can kill and make alive. Worship the one that will break the jaw that nobody can shut. Your greatness is everlasting. Your mighty hand is everlasting. Faithful Father, glory be to your name. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, we have worshipped our Daddy God.
Amen.
Our Daddy God, we give you glory.
Hallelujah.
We magnify your name.
Yes, Lord.
There's no one like you. Everlasting, everlasting, you reign as God.
Yes, Lord.
Nobody, oh God, can be compared with you. You are great. You are great. You are the master of the universe. Unchanging, changer. Aruba Wacho is your name. The lily of the valley is your name. Okemiri Nepokwe is your name. Eternity that inhabits eternity is your name. We bow before you, Lord God Almighty, for you are the soon coming King. Rakalebo Kosota Lagalatea. We say, Siabonga. Siabonga. Glory be to your holy name. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, precious Redeemer.
Thank you, Lord.
For gathering us again, Lord, in the ninth hour of prayer with you, O God. Thank you, Lord God Almighty, for bringing us to the 15th hour. O Sakota Lagalatea. We give you the glory. For the daughter of 15 years has entered puberty. Maturity has started. Rakalepo Kotoria. Understanding has started. She can now begin to do things. Rakalabokosuna without supervision. Kutalagalepo Kotoria Galantea. Lord, we are grateful. While you are training us, you are training us to be what you want us to be. We do not take it for granted. We are super grateful. Blessed be your name, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We surrender to you, Lord God Almighty. Father, search our hearts, examine us, Lord. Whatever doesn't glorify you in us, we ask for your mercy. And your blood cleanse us, O Lord. Wash us from every sin, Lord. Thank you for your son, your daughter over there. That mommy, that daddy that has gathered, O Lord God Almighty, at your feet, O Lord. And the Lord, you will put us, O Lord, together in your palm. And minister to us, Lord. And strengthen us, Lord. And help us, Lord. And revive our Lord. Lord will begin, O Lord, to manifest in our lives, O Lord God Almighty. All from this global altar, Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ. Think about the networks now. Thank you, Lord God Almighty, the Facebook management. Everything, Lord God Almighty, about, oh Lord, this prayer time. And it be ordered by you, Daddy. In the name of Jesus Christ. Yeah, the Lord God Almighty, Lord, I thank you for your daughter that continues as well. Yes. Yeah, the Lord, you will lay your hands on us, Lord. Amen. You will strengthen us, Lord, by your power. Let no man see us, but let them see your glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The rapture will take place while we are here, Daddy, let this entire global altar be empty.
Amen.
And all our family members, in the name of Jesus
Christ. Amen.
Thank you, sweet Dad.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
We love you, Dad.
We love you, Dad.
We glorify your name, Daddy. We're not ashamed of you, Lord.
At all.
We give our hands to the whole Lord. And we declare that, Lord, you are majesty. Blessed be your name, Father. In Jesus Christ's unchallengeable name, we have prayed. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God bless you. Amen. Shalom morning. Shalom afternoon. Shalom evening. Shalom night. For those of you that are far off, the Lord God Almighty is with us.
Amen.
It is still the ninth hour with Jesus.
Amen.
God Almighty is with us.
Amen.
He's the one that called us because he's the one that has something for us.
Yes, Lord.
I want to thank God for as many of us that are participating up to this 15th hour. Amen. Child of God, it's not in vain.
Amen.
God Almighty is doing something in our lives.
Amen.
We may not see it physically. Just like a little child that is born, you begin to wonder 6 months after, so much weight, looking so pop, so
yes,
fresh,
yes,
looking so chubby, all over the place. And you wonder, is it just breast milk for those of us that did exclusive?
Yes.
It's bringing so much weight, bringing so much health.
Hallelujah.
To the joy of the child.
Hallelujah.
Spiritually, something is happening in our life.
Oh, yeah.
Physically, may look as if we are still like before. We're not like before.
Amen.
Because God Almighty, when that is true with us,
yes,
he will present what he's going to use as a tester.
Amen.
There's only a God tester. And we are going to pass our test.
Amen.
And the Lord God Almighty say, this is good. Jesus. This is wonderful.
Amen.
That is how you know a teacher that has done well.
Amen.
When the student begins to receive award,
hallelujah,
you see them, they are so proud. They'll be coming to hug the child. The Lord will hug us.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
So come on. Keep pressing on.
Amen.
We will finish well.
Amen.
Just 21 hours. And after that, you'll be hungry for more.
Amen.
You'll become a libertist.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ.
Amen.
Go ahead and continue to invite people. We know what is going on. Just come on and share and invite people. God Almighty will bring such as should be saved.
Amen.
Those that need the message, those that need to pray, he will gather them.
Amen.
Through you in the mighty name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. God bless you.
Amen.
Child of God, there comes a time in our life we begin to ask ourselves, who are we going to believe? Whose reports we will believe?
That's right.
Is it the report of the Lord or the report of the environment? We are those people that walk by faith.
Amen.
Our eyes are dead when it comes to God.
Amen.
These eyes cannot understand God. It's the spirit man inside us. There are eyes inside. There are ears inside that understand God, that hear from God, that perceive from God. God Almighty is preparing us
Amen.
For a major work we are going to do for him.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. We will keep on believing in him.
Amen.
Nobody is qualified to take our minds.
Amen.
Beware of false revelations. Be conscious in your mind. Let nobody come and invade us with lies.
Yes.
God Almighty said, in the last days, there will be false Christs. There will be liars.
Yes.
He warned us. Don't be carried away by all manner of revelations you are hearing. We are focusing on God's word.
Amen.
We are following the Holy Spirit. He's the one that is going to lead us. Say, Kalapasada. Oh, thank you, oh my Father, for giving us your Son and leaving your Spirit here. Your work on earth is done. The Holy Ghost is here to finish the work. The Holy Ghost is here to finish the work.
Amen.
Hey, focus on the heart. Child of God, it is time for us to begin to focus on God. There's a deep scripture we're going to read, and then our sister, my daughter, she's going to lead us as the Lord is helping her.
Amen.
Let's read Hosea chapter 10, verse number 12.
Hosea chapter 10, verse 12.
Yes, sir.
Sow to yourselves in righteousness.
The scripture says we should sow to ourselves.
Amen.
It's farming time.
Yes.
Yes, in righteousness.
Reap in mercy.
Because automatically what we are sowing, we are going to reap it in form of mercy.
Amen. Amen.
This will not become easy for us.
Amen.
We will not struggle to serve God.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Break up your fallow ground for
then
it's
time
we'll
to seek the Lord.
Then
we'll be able to respond. It will be responding time.
Amen.
God says we're going to respond.
Amen.
We'll break up fallow grounds. All the things that have been so hard before, it's not be easy to drop them.
Amen.
Yes.
Till they come and rain righteousness upon
and
you.
And when God sees that we are done, he's the one that will come and rain righteousness
Amen.
Upon us in the name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. Child of God, there's a God that is going to finish us.
Yes.
Fear not. He knows when we are ready for him.
Yes.
He will not die before your time.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We shall eat and enjoy the fruit of our labor.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.
I want to hand over to my daughter now, Atike, to lead us.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen. Thank you, mommy. Shalom afternoon, mommies and daddies. Uncles, aunties, you're all welcome in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I thank the Lord for another great opportunity. I call it a rare privilege to come into his presence, and we do not take it for granted.
Yes.
Father, we are grateful.
Oh,
blessed be your name, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
We give you praise, oh God, in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Brother, this afternoon, the Lord wants to talk to us and then lead us to pray.
Yes.
But he began this word since yesterday. And he said to us yesterday that we should be zealous to repent.
Yes.
And today again, as I tarried before the Lord, he brought me back to the same word, repent. And there was Satayada. So I want us to quickly open to the scripture, Revelations chapter 2. Revelations chapter 2, I'm just going to read verse 5. It's a scripture that we all know as children of God, but we'll just look at verse 5.
Revelation chapter 2, verse 5.
Yes.
Remember therefore from whence thou art fallen, and repent, and do the first works, or else I will come unto thee quickly, and will remove thy candlestick out of his place, except thou repent.
Amen. You can hear repent repeating itself there. When you go back, please read from verse 1. You will see the church there. But the Bible says the angel was speaking to the church at Ephesus. And the Bible says God said, God praised the church. He said, you have done well. He said, I know you. I know your works. I know your labor. I know your patience. I know how you cannot bear evil. Anything evil, you cannot withstand it. I know how much you have been tried. I know how much you have tested those people. People there that say they are apostles, but they are not. I know how much you have put into to show that these people, to prove that these people are not actually of God. You have proven them, and they have been found to be liars. I know all that you are doing and all that you have done, how you have borne, how you have had patience for the sake of the name of the Lord. You have labored, you have been through so much. But God says, if revival must come, we must repent.
Yes.
He said, we must repent. I was asking, I said, Lord, repent. He said, yes, go to Revelation chapter 2, verse 4. He said, nevertheless, I have somewhat against you.
That's right.
Brethren, there's one prayer we have always prayed on this global altar, that Lord, let there be no spots on my dress. As my mother came in this afternoon, she didn't know that she started preaching the word. I was just listening to her. I refused to talk, but she continued from where the Lord began with me, and she kept on speaking. Mom, God will bless you. Ah, brethren, the Lord is calling us back. What is that thing that we have been doing? We have been so busy. We have been so busy with activities, programs, here and there, running back and front. The Lord says he recognizes it. The Bible says he will not forget our labor of love. But that is not more important. It is not as important as relationship. It is not as important as fellowship. It is not as important as our time alone with the Lord. And so the Lord is calling us back. He says repent. That word repent means to turn back. Turn back. The Bible says in the book of Genesis chapter 3, if you check verse 8, you will hear the Lord talking to man from the beginning. God is always interested in our fellowship. As much as we do activity, they are good, but he is more interested in our fellowship and our relationship with him. Verse 8 of Genesis chapter 3.
And they heard the voice of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day.
Hallelujah.
And Adam and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God amongst the trees of the garden.
Amen. The cool of the day can be any time.
Yes.
Brethren, the cool of the day does not mean evening. For your own cool of the day may be the early hours of the morning.
Yes.
My own can be in the afternoon. The other person's own can be in the evening. Some other person can be in the midnight. But there is a specific time that you meet with the Lord. He calls it the cool of the day. The Bible says he came as at other times. God has been coming, but we have been so busy. Jesus said to Martha, he said, Martha, Martha, thou art encumbered. You are so depression. You are so troubled about so many things. Mary has found the right thing. And that is his presence. That's all that God is talking about. That's all that God is interested in. That's why he called us this month and he said, come and tarry before me. I want our fellowship back. I want our relationship back. The book of Revelation chapter 2, where we read, it says, go back to your first love. Where we first begun. Where we used to sit together, where we used to stay together, where you could tarry and say, Daddy, unless you speak, I will not go out. Where you were ready to spend several hours and nothing bothered you. You were not concerned or constrained by time nor any activity. Nothing was moving you. You could forget about friends and family and relations. You were not pushed about because of money or achievement. You just wanted to be with the Lord. Brethren, the Lord is hungry again for that relationship. He's calling you and I back. He says, come back, come back, come back. Repent, return, return, return. Let's come back to where we first begun. Our Father wants to relate with us. We have been outside for too long. We have been busy about his business and we are wearing out. We are wearing out. Child of God, I am wearing out. You are wearing out because we are busy about activities. And what we do not know is that except he helps us, we cannot even achieve those activities. The Bible says that he called his disciples that they should be with him, and then that he might send them out. There must be a being with the Lord before we can go out. We have carried on with too many activities, but the Lord says we should come back. He said, I have somewhat against you, though you have done well. Brethren, it is a privilege that God can call you and say, my child, there is something that I am holding against you. It is better for us now to correct it than for us to meet it at that gate. And we are told to depart. Child of God, you will not be told to depart. As the Lord is calling us back today, we will return back to him. If all there is that we just stay with him, it is enough. It is enough. It is enough, child of God, because the world out there is so noisy, pushing us with pressure left, right, and center. People are confused, people are troubled, people, all manner of things. Yet, in the presence of the Lord, the Bible says there is fullness of joy. At his right hand are pleasures. Whatever it is that is troubling us out there is at his right hand. It is called pleasure. It is called pleasure. If we can just stay with him, see that his right hand, he says he can give it to us. He gave everything to Adam in the Garden of Eden. And yet he came and said, I want to have fellowship with man. Child of God, the Lord is calling you and I back. He says, repent. I have somewhat against you. You no longer tarry before me. I no longer relate with you. You no longer hear from me. You no longer see my face. You are not seeking my face again. Our anchor scripture says, till he comes. Till he comes. Till he comes. And reign righteousness. Till he comes. Brethren, it's time for us to tarry. It's time for us to seek his face. Let's return. Let's live outside. There comes a time when, as a child of God, you must live outside and enter inside. If you don't enter inside, you might be swept off. The days ahead are so dangerous that if you are not prepared from inside, you will be swept off. The Lord told us earlier this year to kid ourselves. He says, put on the whole armor. Such dressing is not done outside. It is done inside. And then when you appear, the enemy is afraid of you because he doesn't know what you are carrying. He does not know the potential that is inside of you. He doesn't know what you are made up of. He does not know the kind of armory that you are possessing. He does not know at what point to attack from. For you have been fortified from inside. The Lord says, let's come back inside. Come back to your first love, son. Come back to your first love, daughter. Come back to your first love, mother. Come back to your first love, daddy. Come back. The Lord is calling us. Let's return. Let's return. Let's return. It is only when we return that the Lord can show us mercy. It is only when we return that the Lord can tear off our apron and give us a coat. It is only when we return that the Lord can bless us again. It is only when we return. Except we return, the serpent will not be cursed for our sake. All the prayers of fall and die cannot have any effects until we return.
Yes.
Until we come to him again. Child of God. God, the Lord is calling us back. God. I don't know who you are today. I don't know where you are today. But I beg you, it is time for us to return. The Lord has given you an applause. He said you have done well. He said he recognized it, all your activities. But he is saying to you today that beyond his acts are his ways. And you do not find his ways outside. You find it in his presence. When you tarry, he begins to tell you, this is what I want. This is what I desire. This is what I love. My mother will always say, daughter, this is what I love. Daughter, this is what I love. Daughter, this is what I love. She doesn't say it outside. She says it inside. She will say, come inside. Come inside, daughter. Sit here. This is what I love. Child of God, the Father is calling us. Let's come back inside. The Lord wants to prepare us. The Lord wants to get us up. The Lord wants to remove whatever is a stain on our garment. Ah, because at that gate, there will be no excuse. Child of God, let nobody deceive you. That when you stand there, you can do praise and worship. The Lord is not destitute of praise. If he was destitute, he has enough angels. He said, if you won't praise me, I will raise up stones. God will not raise up stones in our place. But child of God, listen to me. God is not destitute of praise. For he existed before the world. He is God all by himself. The Bible says the winds, the waves, the leaves of the tree, they wave sideways. They are praising him. You can hear the voice of the little child crying. No, saying nothing, but he's praising the Lord. For he said, out of the mouth of babes and sucklings, he has obtained praise. So he's not looking for praise, child of God. Enough of trying to think that you can use praise to bribe God. No way. No way. If there's no relationship, you cannot bribe him. The praise does not ascend. For your praise is a form of prayer. And he said the prayers of a sinner is an abomination to the Lord. So he doesn't even hear it. So don't waste your time. It's time to return to the Lord. It's time to repent. It's time to take a 180 degree turn and say, Daddy, I come back home. Daddy, I come back home. And wherever you are, I want us to come to the Lord this afternoon. And let's begin to bow our heads even as we begin to pray. The Lord says in Isaiah 57 verse 15, he says, a broken and a contrite heart, that's the one he will do. Ah, so please, can you just help me read that scripture before we begin to pray? I wanted us to pray, but the Lord is bringing back that scripture. Isaiah chapter 57. Verse 15.
For thus saith the high and lofty one that inhabited eternity.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Whose name is holy. I dwell in the high and holy place.
Yes.
With him also that is of a contrite and humble spirit. To revive the spirit of the humble and to revive the hearts of the contrite.
Brethren, the Lord is calling us. There is a place that he dwells. There's a dwelling place of the Lord. If you must receive revival, there's a place you must come to. It is called his dwelling place. He says he dwells in a high and a holy place. Ah, with the contrite and humble of spirit. That is the place where the Lord dwells. That's where the Lord is calling us back to the place of holiness, to the high and holy place. Child of God, let's return. Can you go down on your knees even this afternoon as we begin to pray and begin to cry out to the Lord and say, Father, thank you. Thank you for your word. Thank you for sending me your word today. Thank you for your word, oh God, that you have sent to me. Oh, Makuli Brakataya, Ah, Lord, in this season of revival, you are settling everything that concerns me, that my revival, oh God, will come. Thank you, oh God, for your word. Thank you, I receive it, oh God, with your oneness of us. Ah, Makuli Brakataya, Brakataya, Ekatotale Brakalabosotori, in Jesus Christ's mighty name, we have prayed. Child of God, do you know that you and I are so privileged? The Lord didn't make us as a mosquito. He didn't make us like any other animal. The Bible says we are made in his image and likeness. What a privilege. He is God all by himself. Scripture declares that he sits in the heavens. The earth is his footstool. Yet when it is time for fellowship, fellowship. He leaves all the glory in heaven. He leaves all the praises in heaven. He comes down and he says, I want to fellowship with Kate. Ah, what a privilege. What a privilege. What a privilege. Child of God, can you lift up your voice one more time and say, Daddy, thank you for this real privilege. I didn't understand it like this before, that you love me so much. You just want to be with me. You come at the cool of the day. Ah, that time, oh God, that is so convenient, oh God, that to meet with me. That's when you come. And when you come, you don't allow, the place is not earthquaking. When you come, the place is not checking. You just come in. You just come in. And you are looking around for me. You are looking for me. You are searching for me. And I am the one who walked out of the place that you came to me. You are the one looking for me. Ah, thank you for your love. Thank you for your love. Thank you for your love. Thank you for your love, Daddy. I am grateful, oh God. Blessed be your name. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, we are praying. Brethren, like the Lord told us here today, the cool of the day is that particular time. If you have given your life to Jesus, there is a time that you normally meet with the Lord.
That is true.
Child of God, cast your mind back.
That is it.
That is why you need to ask yourself, am I truly a child of God?
Yes.
Because if genuinely you are, there is a time that you meet with the Lord.
Yes.
And child of God, I can clearly tell you that whensoever that time reaches, even if you were so deep in slumber, there's a hand that taps you. I have experienced it severally. And then I will wake up and say, ah. And once I check the time, oh, I will say, thank you, Lord.
Thank you
came to wake me because it's time for fellowship. And the minute you begin to pray, his presence is all over the place. He's talking to you. He's speaking to you. He's declaring his mind to you. Child of God, you are going to lift your voice and say, Father, I return.
Back
to the place of our fellowship. Can you lift your voice and pray that prayer? And say, Father, I return. Father, I return. Back to the place of our fellowship. I am the one that walked away. I am the one that walked away. Ah, Lord, I return. Lord, I return. Lord, I return. Back to the place of our fellowship, Lord. Father, I return. Back to the place of our fellowship. The place of the cool of the day. The place where we stand. Lord, I return. I return, Lord. I return, Lord. I return, Lord. Lord, I return. Lord, I return. Out of the place of our fellowship, oh God. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Brethren, do you know that it was in this place of fellowship where God was talking with Adam that he saw that Adam was lonely, and he said, it is not good for man to be alone. It was not Adam that suggested to the Lord. They were just in fellowship. Two lovers. And he looked at Adam. He said, it's not good for this one to be alone. Look at animals, they are in twos. He was looking at his creation, that there was nobody to praise him and impress himself. The Bible says he looked at everything that he created and he said it was very good. That's why you cannot use praise to mesmerize him. Because he's a praiser himself. When there was nobody to praise him, he praised himself. He said it is very good. He congratulated himself, sir. You cannot mesmerize God with your praise. You cannot mesmerize God with your voice. He praised himself by himself. Child of God, what is that thing that is carrying you away? What is that thing that has drawn you away from the place of fellowship? What is that thing that has taken your attention? Do you know that the Lord can take care of it?
Yes.
The scripture says, at his right hand are pleasures. What is pleasure? Anything that will gladden your heart. Anything that will make your heart to be sweetened. Anything that will make you to be at peace. The Bible says it is at his right hand. At his right hand. So wherever he is and he's all over, it is at his right hand. Why are you going outside when what you are looking for is at his right hand? You are going to pray for yourself again. I'm going to pray for yourself because the Lord gave me this scripture. He said, daughter, it is for you first.
Lord, thank you, Jesus.
That's what he said to me. He said, it is for you first.
Thank you, Lord.
And I began to cry to the Lord. I said, Lord, I repent. Lord, I return. Lord, I repent. Can you pray the same prayer I prayed? Lord, I repent. Lord, I return. I'm sorry for walking away. I'm sorry for leaving the place where we used to meet. It used to be such a beautiful time. It was a time I looked up to. Just the same way you looked up to it, so I looked up to it. I do not know how I walked away. I don't know what it was that dragged me away. But Father, I return. Daddy, I return. Daddy, I return. I return, Lord. I return, Lord. I return, Lord. I return. 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 I return, Lord.
I return, Lord.
Take me back,
yes, Lord,
to the place where we started. Oh Lord, I pray, please, Lord, take me back. Take me back to the place where we started. Oh Lord, I pray. Where we fellowshiped together, where we talked together, where I could hear you laugh, where I could hear, when you could say to me, daughter, I am not happy, when you could say to me, daughter, the people have gripped my heart, when you could say to me, daughter, go and tell them, this is what I say, Rika no basotoni kadada, basotoni kalebra sotoya, Raku sotoni kadada, no, please take me back, no, please take me back, please take me back, that I repent, Lord, in Jesus Christ's mighty name, we are praying.
Amen.
Child of God, you are going to cry to the Lord and say, Lord, I am sorry.
Sorry, Lord.
I'm sorry for walking away.
Sorry,
Lord. But you had to come looking for me. I am the one who is supposed to wait for you. But you came to the place of fellowship. I was no longer there. Oh God, I needed it. Lord, I am sorry. Lift up your voice, child of God. I said, Lord, I am sorry. I walked away. I left the place, oh God, where we used to meet. I left the place of fellowship. Yet out of your love, you looked for me. Lord, I am sorry. I am sorry. What is it I was looking for? Lord, I am sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I am sorry. I am sorry, Lord. I am sorry, Lord. I went far. I went far. And I no longer heard your voice. I recall myself with things that you told me not to do. Lord, rather than joy that you people are coming. I began to be afraid. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, God. Please show me mercy. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, we are praying.
Amen.
Brethren, it was because man left God's presence. That's why he was afraid. For other times, the Lord will come and have fellowship, and there was no fear.
Yes.
But when I began to mingle, when I began to become interested in other things, when I began to listen out there, I didn't know that I have walked far. I didn't know that I have crossed boundaries where he had told me not to cross. Yet he had good plans for me. What is it I was looking for? I lost the beautiful garment he gave to me. I dropped the beautiful garment. It was when I dropped it, I realized that I was naked. For man was never naked. Man was clothed with the glory of God. The enemy came and deceived man because man has walked away from the covering. Child of God. The Lord said to me, daughter, it is for you first. Then go and declare it to the people. Do you know where your garment is, child of God? Where is the glory and the beauty that the Lord covered you with? The enemy trickishly took it away. Because we walked out. I'm going to cry to the Lord. And say, God, I don't know where I dropped it. But right now I am wearing apron. Apron cannot cover my back. So completely naked behind. My back is exposed. And I can be attacked from the back. Lord, I am sorry. I don't know where I dropped it. I don't know where I dropped it. Child of God, please go ahead and cry to the Lord. He said we should repent. He said we should repent. Our covering has been taken away. Our covering has been lost. Can't you see that you struggle right now to even pray? 15 days you have been in the presence of God and you are still struggling. Does it not call your attention that something is missing? Does it not tell you that something is not in place? The Lord has been speaking. You are struggling to hear. You are struggling to even study your Bible. Return, child of God. The Lord says return. The Lord says return. I return that. I return that. This is all he asked me to say this afternoon. Then we repent and return. Repent and return. Repent and return. For his coming is so close. He said, I will come quickly and I will take away your candlestick if you do not repent. If you do not return. Child of God, the Lord is calling you. Child of God, the Lord is calling me. In this season of revival, let us return. Let us return. Ah, Lord, I return to you. 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 Can you go ahead and cry to the Lord and say, Father, please open the door for me. Let me come inside. I return, Lord. I return, Lord. Open the door of fellowship again, Lord. Open the door of our relationship again. Daddy, I return. Daddy, I return. Daddy, I return. Open the door. Open the door. Open the door. I cannot stay outside again. The emperor cannot cover me. The cold is outside. I return. I return. I return. I return. I return, Daddy. Finally, you are going to pray, because as the Lord opens the door for you, the apron must drop.
Yes.
The Bible says he killed an animal. For without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sins. So the Lord had to kill an animal. Blood had to go. And then the Lord used the skin of that animal and made a coat. A coat completely covers. We're going to cry out to the Lord today and say two prayers in one. You are going to pray because we have to round up now and say, Lord,
Lord,
let the blood of Jesus,
blood of Jesus,
purge me.
Purge me.
For that is a type of the blood of Jesus in the Garden of Eden.
Yes. Yes,
there
yes.
was a purging by the blood. Yes, yes. Let the blood of Jesus purge me today. Father, please release back unto me a new coat. Yes. Can you lift your voice and pray that prayer for yourself and say, Father, let the blood of Jesus purge me. Lord. Father, please purge me by the blood of Jesus. For I went out to God and all manner of things, oh God, has rubbed off of me. And I am dead. Oh God, Father, please purge me by the blood of Jesus. Lord, please purge me by the blood of Jesus. Purge my conscience, oh God. Purge my heart, oh God. Purge my soul, oh God. Purge my spirit, oh God. Purge me by the blood of Jesus Christ. Lord, I surrender. Release, oh, release afresh unto me a fresh coat, a new coat, oh God, out of your glory. A new covering of your glory, a new covering of your glory, a new covering, oh God, of your glory, the outpouring, oh God, of revival.
Father, we give you praise and worship you, Lord. We magnify your name, Akusutalagalante. What a faithful Father you are, Lakanibra Kusutuya. Lift your voice wherever you are. Family, lift your voice and give God praise. Another opportunity to return to Him. That's all He asks us. That's all He asks us. It's the one that has the power. It's the one that has the outpouring. It's the one that will pour righteousness. It's the one that will give us the grace to be holy. It's the one, it's the one, it's the one. I lift your voice. I say, Lord, I yield to you, Lord. I yield to you, Lord. I yield to you, Lord. I yield, Lord. I yield, Lord. You are my hiding place. You are. I yield, Lord. I yield, Lord. I yield, Lord. I yield to you, Lord. I thirst for you, Lord. I'm desperate for you, Lord. I yield to you, Lord. Oh, Lord. Keep on praying. Keep on praying, child of God. Don't be cold in the place of prayer. Keep on praying.
Desire and I long to
to seek you.
To want to worship you.
To want to worship you.
Father, fill me with hunger. To be your presence. Dwelling daily. With you in fellowship. In intimacy. I want to know you. I want to know you. Inside. I want to know you. As you are. I want to know. In Jesus Christ, mighty name we are praying. Child of God, God Almighty calls us to the secret place. The secret place, where nobody else knows. When you mention secrets, it means nobody else knows.
Yes.
It's not about going to the mountain to pray and you go with video camera. That is not the secret place. The secret place is the place where you have shame toward people. You are shy to people. You don't want them to see you. The secret place is a deep place. When you look to the left, you look to the right. You make sure nobody's watching. It's not for social media. Cry to God and say, Father, help me to develop a secret place with you. Oh, lift your voice and cry to God. So develop a secret place. With you are you alone. Now flesh and blood does not understand. Now angels cannot enter. I call them about children. A place of you and me. A place of you and me. Speaking you and small me. Speaking you and small me. In a shaken place. In a shaken place. A place that has no limitation. No barrier. A shaken place. Where I can be myself with you. Oh, Kalatalataya. Say Kakakakakakataya. Oh, Kakakakakataya. Let there be a rain over my life, over my father. suddenly. I need a fire. Somebody cry to the Lord, I need a fire. I need a fire. Fire of the Holy Ghost. I need a fire. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, we are praying. Child of God, when you begin to go deep in prayer, you don't know that the time is gone. What a faithful Father. What a training time. What a time of drawing. Drawing us to Himself. Oh, Lord, God bless you. God bless you, my family. God bless you, my loved ones. God bless you, heaven-bound people of God. God Almighty is with us. He's going to continue to strengthen you to pray. As we round up this time, you will keep on praying. Don't stop praying. Keep on praying. The Lord is doing a great work in our lives as individuals, as family, in the mighty name of Jesus. If Jesus tarries, we're going to meet tomorrow by 3 p.m. for the 16th hour. Child of God, don't be tired. Child of God, you are almost there. God is about to put a ceiling upon our lives. We'll never remember the same again. Shalom, shalom, the rest of the day. Love you plenty, plenty, plenty. Heaven is our home. Heaven is our beautiful home. We're not going to miss it. In the name of Jesus Christ. God bless you. God bless and preserve you. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, we are praying. When we pray, say, Father. Let the revival begin to spread all over the nations. Lift your voice, spread your hands, wave your hands. Let the revival spread all over the nations. Oh, my God, revival rain all over the nations. Let there be no massive revival. To you, let men shake you, let men run to you, let the children come to you, let the teenagers run to you. Hunger for God, hunger for God, all over the nations, hunger for God. Oh, and we run to